What's going on? My name is Max, straight out of East London, and you're watching Red Carpet News.
Maxa, thank you so much for joining us here today. We're here at your label, Sony. Now, first up, Wanna Go is officially out on Sunday. Can you tell us a little bit about the track?
Basically, it's like it features Lil Nicky. It's produced by my producer. His name is Show Improve. He did like the rest of my earlier stuff that I'd done last year. And basically, there's not too much to it other than that it's just like a feel-good track. We really wanted to make something that people want to listen to, like something that's really going to be in the clubs, really going to be on the radio, and people want to drive along to and get a bit gassed.
Well, I'll tell you what as well, I mean, you've sort of come through the underground doing mixtapes, EPs. Mm-hmm. When are we going to hear like the first full studio album?
I guess it's all like, it all stems from people buying your singles and then actually creating that fan base who will buy your album. So I say, as long as like Wanna Go does well, the next one and the one after that does well, I'm really itching to give people an album. I'm excited to. So it's like, it just has to come. You know?
Well, there's a line in the track as well called "Let Me Take You Down Shoreditch."
Yeah.
What do you do when you go out? Is that the sort of place you find yourself on a night out?
Yeah, you might catch me at. I'm there less now because it's a bit like bait and stuff. But Brick Lane, Vibe Bar, Big Chill. I'm in those places. I'm literally in there. Just going like that. So yeah, that's what it was, and it was like when I envision a party and stuff like that, I envision a place like Shoreditch, a trendy place, loads of interesting looking people and stuff.
Is it important to you to talk about your real life and be real in that sense?
Yeah, because I guess that's the only thing that I can talk about that no one else can talk about. Literally, it's the only thing I have.
And on the track as well, you got Lil Nicky. You've also done a remix of I Wanna Rock. It's got Rizzle Kicks, Lady Leisure, Tinchy Strider on it. What's it like working with these UK artists?
It's pretty cool because they don't have to work with me at all. So I appreciate the love. And it's just cool to know that I might not be where I want to get, but people who have like got to places I would like to be myself, they look down from up there and rate me, and will sit in the studio with me, and we're mates and we chill and have a laugh. So I just appreciate it, man.
Jordan and Harvey especially look like a real laugh to work with. Yeah. What is it like working with those guys?
Like Harvey was like sitting there and just saying some shit here and there, and Jordan's just up, just like, yo Max, blood, listen to this. Like it's just, yeah, they're really like fun and energetic, and it's just like when we're in the studio, it's just a bunch of jokes that we can't say in public. It's really cool.
The UK music scene is so strong at the moment. Is there anyone that you particularly look up to in the UK and would like to work with?
Dizzy Rascal, definitely. Because there's people that I look up to but I've worked with them, like Wiley and stuff. But someone like Dizzy Rascal is like, obviously I'd never say I'm trying to be Dizzy Rascal because my music doesn't sound like Dizzy Rascal's, but in terms of his effect and his like career, and like I could only wish to like do even half of that. Yeah.
Well, I'll tell you what, as someone who remembers when Boy in the Corner came out, you're very similar to Dizzy, and lots of people do compare you to him, and you're sort of the first person who's been like him for a while. Do you like those comparisons, or do you want to be yourself?
Obviously, of course I want to be myself, but I can't take away from the fact that I was once a kid watching him on TV, and now the odd person might put me and him in the same sentence. That's awesome.
So if you collaborated, what would you guys do together? Because he's always trying to find different sounds. What do you imagine the track sounding like?
Like one of the best songs ever or something. I don't know. But I just know it would be crazy. Yeah.
And how about the States? A lot of Brit artists are going out to the States at the moment, working over there. Is that something you're looking at long term?
Nah, man, because, well, obviously, yeah, that would be nice. But, like, think about it like this. Dizzy Rascal is doing that kind of... Now, he's done it here and there in parts of his career, but he's doing that comfortably now, 10 years in. So I just feel like I'm from Britain. I just need to be here and do my thing. I ain't really watching that, like, yet.
And I mean, what else is next for you as well? I mean, what are your plans for the rest of 2013 and looking into next year as well?
I've got like my next single. I think that I don't know when it's gonna come out, but it'll be pretty soon. I'm excited to like shoot the video and all that kind of stuff, because what we've started to really do is like like I say, is a page that I could take out of Dizzy's book, but it's like a really sick way of like coming across to people is by having these exciting, relatable visuals. Like I did Wanna Go like on the bus. Dizzy has that one where he's a parking attendant, like he's a parking officer. He's like, that as well though. But you know, like he's in America, but he's got the British cab. It's just stuff like that that relates to where we're actually from, because that's why I say like it's all fun and games going over to America, but you could just as easily be lost in the sea of all of them, and there's so many better people for suited to their scene. Like I can't beat Kendrick Lamar or Drake or Kanye West, so that's their country, that's their sound, hip hop. I'm Maxter from England, and I'm just trying to do that.
Well, that's one of those things. I mean, a lot of sort of what were initially grime artists in this country have gone quite pop, and it sounds poppy and electro. Mm. Do you feel like you're reclaiming grime music, doing something a little bit different?
You know what? Because obviously, grime to me is also like a lifestyle as well. It's just like, even if I made a song like Wanna Go, you could say is not grime. But in terms of like the conventional things that you might hear in a grime song, there's a few of them in there. Alcohol, drinks, blowing O's or whatever, yeah, you know?
And you think, I mean, because it has gone very mate. I mean, lots of people working with people like Calvin Harris and stuff. I mean, would you like to work with those pop artists, or would you like to keep it more raw?
No, you know what? I feel like people like that are very talented and they can make anything they want. So if I was in the studio with them, we would definitely find a common ground where we would make something exciting without me just being like, yo, guys, I just want to make a straight out pop record and just sell myself on this one. I'm sure that someone like Calvin Harris would make me still come across interesting, but maybe amplify me in terms of that direction. Okay. Yeah.
And finally, have you got a message for fans, people who are supporting you and sort of watching you on your way up?
Yeah, man, just keep watching, because I've been doing music I've been recording songs since I was like 14, and I'm 21 now. And I still feel like I haven't even seen nothing yet of what I have to give. So I'm really here for the long run, man.